Good morning to everyone. So we are in the discussion of numerical calculations, that is problems, numerical problems related to power measurement through wattmeter. That means we are calculating the power factor, we are observing the behavior of power factor, and we are observing the behavior of wattmeter readings. Okay, so in classroom discussions, we have gone through Blondel's theorem, we have gone to three phase four wire three wattmeter method, three phase two wattmeter method, one wattmeter method, okay, and all these theoretical studies, and we also concluded the theoretical analysis. So in previous class we solved some problems. So on the time constraint, we solved only six problems in previous class. Today we will solve some more problems. Okay, so if you have any doubts with respect to the discussion or with respect to the problem solving techniques, just let me know in the chat box. Okay, so make yourself useful with scientific calculator. So if you don't have scientific calculator, just use the scientific calculator application which I provided in WhatsApp. Just click on that link, you will be directed to Google Play Store, and you can download the scientific calculator application, so you can make yourself comfortable with this. Okay, it's very nice application. So coming into the discussion today, so we'll solve some problems. So first problem, so if we see here, so it is a discussion of two wattmeter method. So two wattmeters are there. Two wattmeters will measure a power of input around 1.5 kV, okay, and at a frequency of 50 hertz. So it's a three phase motor. So it is loading at a, it is running at a full load efficiency of 85%. Okay, the reading of two wattmeters are 250 kilowatts and 80 kilowatts respectively. So this is the given data we got. So what we need to calculate, we need to calculate the input power, we need to calculate the power factor, okay, we need to calculate the line current, and as well as output. Okay, so what is the actual solution we got means, so the motor is actually running at full load condition. So when the motor is running at full load condition, the power factor is greater than 0.5. So at what particular instant this power factor is greater than 0.5 means, when other wattmeter W2 is reading a positive reading. Okay, so let us see W1 is reading, if from the given data we know that W1 is reading at 250 kilowatts and W2 is reading at 80 kilowatt. So how to calculate input power, first one. Okay, we know the input power is calculated with respect to input power, it is also known as true power. So how can we calculate input power or true power? Input power or true power is calculated with the summation of two wattmeter readings. W1 represents 250 kilowatt and W2 represents 80 kilowatt. So what is the total power we got? What is the total power? Calculate it. What is the total true power we can see here in this calculation? Solve along with me, so it will be simple. What is the true power we got? 250 plus 800, 330 kilowatts. 330 kilowatts. Is it the same? 207, right? 330 kilowatts, right? So the input power or input true power, that is 250 plus 80, that is 330 kilowatts. So first thing is solved. First bit is solved. So what is the second bit? Second bit, we need to calculate power factor. We need to calculate power factor. So how to calculate power factor? Power factor is represented as cos phi, cosine of angle between voltage and current. Okay, so in order to calculate cos phi, we need to calculate the phi. We need to calculate phi. So first we have to calculate the below thing, that is tan phi, that is equal to root 3 of W1 minus W2 by W1 plus W2. We know the value of W1, that is 250 kilowatts. We know the value of W2, that is 80 kilowatts. Okay, so substitute the terms here. In the place of W1, I substituted 250 kilowatts. In the place of W2, I substituted 80 kilowatts. That is 250 minus 80 divided by 250 plus 80. Okay, what is the answer? Solve and post your answer in the chat box. What is the answer? Root 3 into 250 minus 80 divided by 250 divided by 80. 212 got 0.89. Right. Anyone just cross verify this thing? 231 right to 0.82. I myself got 0.8. Anyone? 248 got 0.82. Okay. At 0.8 or something, right? Let me check. The answer is 0.892. So after calculating the tan phi, next we need to calculate the angle. So what is the behavior of angle? Angle, how can we represent the angle? Angle phi is equal to, we need to calculate phi. In order to calculate the power factor cos phi, tan phi is equal to 0.892. Phi is equal to tan inverse of 0.892. What is the description of phi? Like 212, angle phi is 41.6, right? Anyone? 207, 41.74, 231, 41.732. Okay, let me check the answer. The angle is 41.74. So we know the description of phi. Now let us calculate cos phi, the power factor. Cos phi, the power factor, that is equal to cos of 41.74. Okay, what will be the angle of power factor? The power factor will be around, the power factor is 0.746. Right. 207 got 0.746. And 212 got 0.747. Okay, let me check the answer. Post your answers in the chat box. 246 got 0.746. Okay. 258, 0.62. It's a different thing, 0.62. Let me verify. The cos phi is 0.746. Cos phi value is 0.746. Next. That is about, we solved the second problem, second bit. First problem, second bit. We calculated the first bit, that is input true power. Next, we calculated the input power factor, that is 0.746. Okay, third bit, that is line current. Line current. How to calculate line current? Line current is represented with respect to the acronym, that is I suffix L. Okay, so from the true power expression, what is the true power expression? P is equal to √3 into VLIL cos phi. Okay, so √3 into VLIL cos phi. So from that expression, so if we substitute that, so if we derive the line power expression, IL is equal to total power P divided by √3 into VL cos phi. Okay, what is the value of VL here? We got, see, the value of VL, what is the value of true power? We got, already we know the true behavior of true power, that is 330 into 1000 divided by √3 into, okay, 330 kilowatts, that's why represented in a normal power, 330 into 1000, that is equal to √3 into, what is the value of EL? EL is nothing but total line voltage. Total line voltage, what is the line voltage represented in the problem? That is 1.5 kilowatt. So that is √3 into 1.5 into 1000 into power factor cos phi. What is the value of cos phi? 0.746. Solve along with me. Students, please solve along with me so that there won't be any confusion. Parallel ka natho pat solve cheyandi. Meeku ana doubts unte chat box lo you can ask your doubts in the chat box. Okay, what is the value of IL? Solve this thing. 330 into 1000 divided by √3 into 1.5. Let me check the chat box. IL is around 170.26 amperes. Total got 170.26 amperes. 258 got 170.2 amperes. Anyone cross verify this thing? Let me check. The answer, the actual line current we got is 170.27 amperes. So that's where we solved the third bit, line current, right? 248 got 170.26. 231 got 170.264, right? It's correct. 258 got 170.2, it's correct. Okay, so that's where we solved the third bit. Okay, so if you have any problem, if you have any queries with these three bits, just let me know in the chat. I'm going to the fourth bit, that is nothing but calculation of output power. Calculation of output power. So if we go to the next bit, calculation of output power. Output power is nothing but output power is nothing. How can we define output power means? So output power, that is equal to input power multiplied with efficiency of total load. Okay. So what is the efficiency of total full load which we got in the problem? Efficiency of total load which we have given, that is 85%. Efficiency is 85%, we know. So what is the input power? Already we calculated the input power, that is 330 kilowatts. Okay, 330 into 0.85. What is the thing here? Output 330 into 0.85. But many people are getting the same answer. 250 got 280.5, 252 got 280.5, 248 got 280.5, 246 got 280.5. Let me check the answer. The answer is 280.5 kilowatt. Okay, so this is about the first bit we solved. So here we calculated the input true power, summation of two wattmeter readings. We calculated the power factor. Okay, and next we calculated the line current. So with the help of total power expression, that is P is equal to root 3 into VLIL cos phi. And next we calculated the output power. Right. Someone posted a query in the chat box. Current reading is generally low, but how it is 170 amperes. So this is nothing but a theoretical thing. Here we're calculating a numerical analysis actually. So it is a three phase load. It is a three phase load and we are reading at an actual voltage of 1.5 kV. That may be a normal industrial load. That's why the behavior of line current is quite high. I too got the same thing. I just verified the answer. But what is the thing means here? It is an industrial load. What may be the industrial load? Either it may be a medium type industrial load or bulk industrial load. But the line rating is 1.5 kV, three phase line. And the two wattmeter readings are around 250 kilowatt and 80 kilowatt. These are very, very high readings. At this instant of high readings, we may get a current rating of 170.2 amperes. So this type of current rating, generally in a wattmeter readings, the current rating is very, very less. It's correct, theoretically. But if we observe the industrial emphasis, when we are dealing with the high burdens, the current rating may be quite exceeded than the normal theoretical reading. Is it clear? Is my explanation clear? Okay, thank you. So this type of current ratings will be experienced with respect to industrial loads, either whatever it may be the type of industrial load. Okay, so if we see the second problem, so two wattmeters are used to measure power input of a synchronous motor. So here he described the big type of load. It is a synchronous motor and each indicates 60 kilowatts. Okay. That means W1 indicates 60 kilowatts and W2 indicates 60 kilowatts. So if the power factor is changed to 0.866 reading, determine the reading of two wattmeters, the total input power remaining the same. Okay. So how can we solve the issue means, we know each wattmeter is reading 60 kilowatts. That means both wattmeters, in two cases we will solve this problem. What is the first case means? Two wattmeters are reading the same equal reading and both are positive. Okay. And motor is running at a unity power factor. Okay. So second discussion, what is the second discussion means? If the power factor is leading, he said, if the power factor is changed to 0.86 lead, what is the behavior of wattmeter readings? That's we can justify. Okay, so we know the behavior of wattmeter reading, that is W1 is equal to VLIL cos of 30 plus 5 and W2 is equal to VLIL cos of 30 minus 5. Okay, so if we substitute the terms and if we solve this thing, okay, W1 plus W2 is equal to root 3 into VLIL cos 5, W1 minus W2 is equal to minus ELIL sin 5. So if we solve these two things, so this is the value of W1 and this is the value of W2. If we summarize both of them, W1 plus W2 is equal to root 3 into VLIL cos 5 and W minus W2 is equal to minus EL into IL sin 5. Okay. So if we summarize the given data, cos 5 is equal to 0.866. What is the value of phi? Phi is equal to cos inverse of 0.86. What is the value of that expression? What is the value of phi? Phi is around 30 degrees. 207 got 30 degrees. It's a simple calculation. There is no need to cross check. Phi is equal to 0.866, 30 degrees. Okay. If we check the remaining data, so tan phi, what is the value of tan phi? Tan phi, phi is equal to 30 degrees, tan phi is equal to 1 by root 3. So if we substitute the values here, tan phi is equal to 1 by root 3, W1 is equal to 60, W2 is equal to 60. If we substitute that parameters here, what is the thing? Tan phi is equal to 1 by root 3. Solve along with me. In your running notes, 1 by root 3, that is equal to minus of root 3 into W1 minus W2 by 120. Okay, what is the value of W1 minus W2? We know W1 plus W2 is 120. Okay, right? So W1 minus W2 is equal to 120 by 3, that is equal to minus 40. Okay, W1 plus W2 is equal to 120, which is already given in the data. So solve equation 1 and equation 2, okay, and answer me what is the value of W1 and W2. What is the value of W1 and W2? So this is a secondary case. So in the first case, we already know both wattmeter readings are equal and positive because the motor is running at unity power factor. This is a second case where the power factor is not unity. It is 0.866 leading. 0.86 leading. That's why we got a secondary issue here. At this secondary issue, we need to calculate the value of W1 and W2. Solve equation 1 and equation 2 and answer me the value of W1 and W2. W1 is 30, W2 is 90. 207 got the same thing, 236 posted the same thing. Anyone? Cross verify this thing. What is the value of W1 and W2? Right, let me check. The value of W1 is 40 kilowatts, the value of W2 is 80 kilowatts. 207 got W1 80, W2, W1 40, W2 80, right? See, so what we solved in this problem? So we have considered two issues here. At the first issues, both wattmeter readings are equal and both are positive and motor is running at unity power factor. What is the second issue? The power factor is 0.86 lag. At that instant of power factor leading, at 0.866, what is the value of W1 and W2? What is the value of W1 and W2? So that's the thing we solved here. So like 217 also got W2 as 80 watts and W1 as 40 watts. So 207 got the same answer. Thank you. I hope this problem is clear. If you have any doubts with this problem, just let me know in the chat box session. So third problem. So third problem, two wattmeters are connected at a reading of, two wattmeters are connected to a reading of total power. of a three-phase system supplying a load of 10 kilowatts and minus 2.5 kilowatts respectively. Okay, so calculate total power and power factor. We need to calculate total power and power factor both. So, and also explain the significance of equal power wattmeter readings. What is the significance of equal wattmeter readings and zero reading at one of the wattmeter? So, what happens if one of the wattmeter is having a zeroth reading? So, what is the given data? So, we need to calculate two conditions. One is at equal wattmeter readings condition, and second one is if one of the wattmeter is zero. So, we know from the given data that is W1 is equal to 10.5 kilowatts. And W2 is equal to minus 2.5 kilowatts. Okay, so from the two wattmeter method, so this is an actual existing two wattmeter method. From the two wattmeter method, we know the actual true power, total power, that is W1 plus W2. What is the value here? 10 minus 2, that is 8, around 8 kilowatts, right? Is it clear? Is the answer same? 8 kilowatts, 252, it's a simple thing. 8 kilowatts. Okay, the total power is 8 kilowatts. Next, we need to calculate the behavior of tan phi. Okay, so W1 minus W2, that is root 3 into 10.5 minus of minus 2.5 divided by 10.5 plus of minus 2.5. It's a simple calculation. Tan phi is 2.8, and the behavior of phi is 70.44. Okay, the behavior of phi is 70.44. So now calculate the power factor here. Now calculate power factor. What is power factor here? What is power factor we got? Cos phi, cos of 70.44, that is 0.335, that is the answer. So from we calculated the power factor at actual total power condition. Next, if we see both of the wattmeter readings are equal, first condition, it is a first case where when both wattmeter readings are equal, both wattmeter readings are equal. What happens if both wattmeter readings are equal? W1, that is equal to W2. What is the expression of W1? That is root 3 EL IL cos of 30 minus 5. What is the value of W2? Root 3 EL cos of 30 plus 5. Okay, so you can cancel it, this thing with respect to this thing. So that is cos of 30 minus 5, that is equal to cos of 30 plus 5. Okay, so what will happen at the total instant if we equalize both of these parameters? Okay, what will happen? The power factor phi is equal to 0. What is the discussion? When power factor phi is equal to 0, when phase angle phi is equal to 0, the power factor will be unity. That means if both wattmeters are having an equal readings, okay, the power factor will be unity. Okay, what is the second thing we got here? The second thing is if one of the wattmeter is reading at the zeroth reading, if one of the wattmeter is having a zeroth reading, so what is the discussion? See here, one of the wattmeter is having a zeroth reading. So W1 is root 3 into ELIL cos of 30 minus 5, and W2 is equal to root 3 into ELIL cos of 30 plus 5. If one of the wattmeter is 0, one of the wattmeter reading is 0. Okay, so and the phase angle is at 60 degrees. So what will be the answer? That is root 3 into ELIL cos phi, that is equal to 0. Okay. So this is about the peculiar discussion with respect to the problem 3. So here it is a two wattmeter method, and we analyzed the discussion when two wattmeters are having an equal readings, and the second case is if one of the wattmeter is having a zeroth reading. I hope it's clear. This is a type of numerical discussion. So if you have any queries with this problem, just let me know in the chat box. I'm moving to the next problem. Fourth problem. See here, it is a two wattmeter method. So two wattmeters are used to measure a balanced load at a load current of 30 amperes, which is having a power factor of 0.8 lagging, and being supplied by a three-phase, three-wire, 440 volt supply. So this is a supply rating. So we need to calculate the total power consumed. We need to calculate the reading of wattmeter number one. We also need to calculate the reading of wattmeter number two. So this is the given data we got. What is the given data? Line voltage, that is 440 volts. Line current is 30 amperes. Power factor is 0.8. Power factor is at 0.8 lagging. Okay. The phase angle phi is equal to, so we know the phase angle, that is from the power factor, phi is equal to cos inverse of 0.8, that is 87 degrees. So this is the given data we got. So from this given data, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate the first bit, that is power consumed. Power consumed. What is the power consumed expression? General power consumed expression, P is equal to root 3 into VL IL cos phi, or root 3 into VL IL cos phi. Line voltage, that is 440 volts substituted here. And the line current is 30 amps substituted here. We know the value of cos phi, that is 0.8, also substituted here. What is the answer? What is the answer of actual power consumed? Just let me know in the chat box. Solve along with me, students. Solve along with me to avoid confusion. I am again repeating and disrepeating this again and again. What is the answer we got here? Chapanandi? What is the value of power we got? I got 16.6 kilowatts. Anybody cross verify this thing? My answer is 16.6 kilowatts. Before we are going to check, is there any problem or something? Right. Let me check the answer. Anyone got the same answer? 18.2 kilowatts, right? Let me just check the second bit. What is the second bit we got? So here we calculated the first bit power consumed. So what is the second bit? Second bit is reading of wattmeter number one. Reading of wattmeter number one. So if we see the answer, how can we check the reading of wattmeter number one? That is equal to, right, okay. So, right. First bit is solved, right? Thank you for your response. So what is the second bit reading of wattmeter number one? That is EL IL cos of 30 minus 5. What is the value of wattmeter number reading one? What is the value of E1? EL? EL is 440 volts. IL is 30 amperes. Okay. Cos of 30 minus 5. What is the value of phi? Phi is equal to 36.87. What is the answer now here? What is the answer here? Around I got 30.15 kilowatt. In my you calculated the thing. Answer is 30.1 kilowatt. Right, 248 got 13.1 kilowatt. Right. Let me check, verify the cross verify this thing. Right, 207 also got 13.1 kilowatt, right, okay. It's correct. So let me check the second reading. 13.1, sir, right, thank you. So if we check the second reading, what may third bit? So what is the third bit we need to calculate? Third bit is nothing but reading of the wattmeter, second wattmeter reading. So if we see, so that is equal to ELIL cos of 30 minus 5. Okay, that is equal to 440 into, okay, 30 into cos of 30 plus 36.87. That means we know the value of line voltage, that is 440. We know the value of line current, that is 30 amperes into cos of 30 degrees plus 5. What is the value of 5? 5 is around 36.87 degrees. Okay, so what is the value we got? What is the value of second wattmeter reading? Just solve it fast. We need to solve some more problems. We are running out of time. It's already 9:40. The 248 got 51.85 kilowatts. 246 got 51.87 kilowatt. 265 got 5.18 kilowatt. 258 got 5.18 kilowatt. Let me check the answer. The answer is 51.85 watts. So most of the people are getting a misconception of converting watts into kilowatts. Okay, so make yourself clear with calculation. Otherwise, there used to be a severe problem. Even if your calculation method is correct, we need to be accurate with the final answer. If your final answer is wrong, that leads to a complete misconception. Okay, see, the cross verify this, right? Thank you everyone for your response. Right, 207 got 5.18. Okay, 235 got 51.585 kilowatts. That's what I'm saying. Right. Okay. So this is the final answer. So here in this problem, this is a 2 watt meter method. So now we calculated the actual power consumed with the first bit. And next we calculated individual watt meter readings with the problems. Okay, this is a pattern of problem. If you have any queries with this type of problem, let me know in the chat box session. So we will discuss the problem, we will discuss the issue. So if we now go to the next problem. Problem number 5. So this is a 3-phase 3-wire system, line voltage of 415 volts. So it is a balanced load of 20 amperes. Okay, which is having a power factor of 0.8 lag. Okay, so current of the wattmeter reading is with R phase. Current of the wattmeter 2 is connected with respect to B phase. Okay, so what we need to calculate means we need to calculate the reading. First reading is across R and Y. First reading when the voltage coil is connected across R and Y. Second reading when the voltage coil is connected across B and Y. And reading one when the voltage coil is connected at Y and B. Okay, so what is the given data we got? We got the given data, a line current that is equal to 415 volts. Line current is 20 amperes. Power factor is 0.8 lagging. That is around 36.87 lag. So when the reading is at first case, if we check the first case discussion, reading it on one when the voltage coil is connected across R and Y. That means when the voltage coil is connected across R and Y, the current coil is connected with respect to R phase, right? Ante kadandi, current coil ante entandi, current element, voltage coil ante entandi, voltage element. Always voltage coil or voltage element is connected parallel across between phases, whereas current coil or current element is connected in series with respect to the line. So here the current coil is connected in series to the R phase, first discussion, where the voltage coil is connected between R and Y. So this is the behavior of wattmeter reading, that is EL, IL cos of 30 minus 5. The value of EL, what is the value of EL we got? The value of EL is 415 watts. The value of IL is 20 amperes. The value of phi is 36.87 lag. Okay, substitute in this and answer me the and answer me the solution of first reading. What is the first reading answer? Answer to me. Is it clear? Always the current coil is connected in series and the voltage coil is connected in parallel. So here the voltage coil is connected between R and Y, and current coil or current element is connected in series to the R phase. So what is the reading here? First wattmeter reading 207 got 8.24 kilowatts. 265 got 8240 watts. 252 got 8.24 kilowatts. Let me check. The answer is 8.24 kilowatts. You need to be fast at finger first. 258, 8.24 kilowatts, right? It's correct. Okay. So second wattmeter reading. So if we see the wattmeter reading second, that is at the wattmeter reading second, the voltage coil is connected across B and Y. Okay. So if the voltage coil is connected between B and Y, the current coil is connected with respect to the B phase. The current coil is connected with respect to the B phase. So how can we solve this type of thing? If the current coil is connected to the B phase and the voltage element is connected between B and Y, this is the line expression, or this is the power expression, that is equal to EL IL cos of 30 minus phi, that is equal to, we know what is the line current, 415. Sorry, what is the line voltage? 415. Line current is 20. Cos of 30 plus phi. What is the value of phi? 36.84. What is the reading here? Right, 212 got 3.26 kV. KV, yeah. Kilowatts kada ravali. Units. You need to be careful with units. 265 got 3.264. Right, okay. 252 got 3.26. Let me check. The answer, that is 3260 watts, that is 3.26 kilowatts. Okay, no issue, right? 212, it's correct, okay. Okay, Andy. So let me check the third. So this is about the second bit. So here the second bit, see the second bit, reading on second wattmeter when the voltage coil is connected across B and Y. That means voltage coil is connected between B and Y. Current element is connected in series to the phase B. Okay, Andy, right. Right, 217 got 3.26 kilowatt, right, okay. So if we see the third bit, so the reading, okay. So the reading of the watt, when the current coil is in phasor one of R phase and voltage coil is connected between Y and B. So this is how we convert the KVR rating here. KVR rating with respect to the line, that is total KVR, that is equal to root 3 into W1 minus W2. Okay. So that is equal to total KVR rating root 3 into W1 minus W2 by root 3. Okay. And what will happen at this condition means this root 3 will get cancelled. Okay. What is the value of W1? W1 is equal to 8.24 kilowatts or 8240 watts. W2, what is the value of W2? W2 is equal to 3260 watts, that is 3.26 watts. Okay, if I subtract both of them, that is the KVR VR rating we got. Okay, that is about the fifth problem. Before going to the sixth problem, so what we did here means we calculated the wattmeter readings when the voltage coil is connected between the phases. At the first bit, the voltage coil is connected in between R phase and Y phase. At the second bit, voltage coil is connected in between B phase and Y phase. Okay. And at the third bit, we have calculated the current coil of one phase is with respect to the voltage coil of other phases. Okay. So if you have any problem with this type of reading, just let me know in the chat. I'm going to the sixth problem. So a star connected three phase load consisting of three similar impedances. When the load is connected to a three-phase 400 volts 50 hertz supply, it takes 30 amperes line current at a power factor of 0.8 lagging. Okay, calculate the total power taken by the load. Calculate the resistance and reactance of each phase type of load. Third bit is, if the power is measured by 2 wattmeter method, then calculate the reading of each wattmeter. So what is the given data? We know the given data, line voltage, that is 400 volts, frequency is 50 hertz, line current and phase current both are equal because it is a balanced load. It is a three phase star connected balanced load with similar impedances. Similar impedances means it is a balanced load. That's why the line current is equal at balanced load condition. From our knowledge of electrical circuit analysis, if it is a balanced load, IL is equal to I phase, that is 30 amperes. Okay, and cos phi, that is 0.8 lagging. Let me check. Right. So it is a balanced load when IL is equal to I line current. It is a balanced load when I line current is equal to phase current of 30 amperes. Okay, and we are having a cos phi, that is the power factor cos phi, that is lag of the 0.8. Okay, 0.8. So if we solve the problem, so what is first we need to calculate? What is the first bit? At the first bit, we need to calculate the total power of the load. Total power, that is equal to root 3 into VLIL cos phi. The line current is 400 volts. And the line voltage is 400 volts and the line current is 30 amperes. And we know the power factor, that is 0.8 lag. Okay, what is the answer? It's a simple thing. Okay, right. 16.6 kilowatts. It's a simple problem, like 258. 2 and 212 got the same answer. Let me verify the thing. Right. That is 16.6 kilowatt. 265 also got the same answer. Right. Thank you. And if we, that is about the first bit. If we solve the second bit, what is the second bit? At the second bit, we need to calculate the resistance and reactance of each phase load, each phase of the load. Okay. So if we solve the second bit, resistance and reactance. So from the line current expression, okay, from the line voltage expression, E phase conversion of phase voltage into line voltage, that is E phase is equal to EL divided by root 3. So this is how line voltage is converted into phase voltage. Here the phase voltage is after conversion, that is 230.95. And if we see the impedances, the load impedance, that is equal to, the load impedance is represented with respect to the expression Z, that is equal to E phase with respect to I phase. That is, we know the value of E phase, that is 230.95 volts. So this is 230.95 volts. We know the load is a three phase star connected balanced load. That's why the line voltage is equal to the phase voltage, and the phase voltage line current is equal to phase current, that is 30 amperes. So the load impedance is 7.7 watts. So how to calculate the load resistance and reactance? That is the second bit. We need to calculate load resistance and reactance. Okay. R is equal to Z cos phi and X is equal to Z sin phi. If we substitute the value of Z, what is the value of Z? We got 7.7 kilowatts, 7.7 into cos phi, that is 0.8 lag. So if we substitute that thing, resistance is equal to 6.16 ohm, and the value of X, load reactance, that is 7.7 into 0.6 sin phi, that is equal to 4.62 ohms. So we calculated the second bit. So if we see the third bit, what is the third bit we need to calculate? At the third bit, we need to calculate power measured power measured by 2 wattmeter method, okay, calculation of the readings at each wattmeter reading. So we need to calculate each wattmeter reading at each wattmeter. So what is the value? W1 is equal to reading at wattmeter 1, that is EL IL cos of 30 plus 5 wattmeter 1, and W2 is equal to EL IL cos of 30 minus 5. So from the power factor cos 5, we know the value of 5, that is 36.9 degrees. So if we substitute them in expression, so answer to me W1 and W2. Solve and answer W1 and W2. Let me check the answers. What is the answer of W1 and W1 answer ఎంత వస్తుందండి? 4.7 kilowatt. I got 4.7 kilowatt. 246 got 4.7 kilowatt. I myself got the same answer. What is the value of W2? W2 I got 11.913 kilowatt. Anyone with W2 11.913 kilowatt? You need to be fast with your calculator, right? 246 got 11.913 kilowatt. Let me check the answer. That is, the value of W1 is 4708 watts or 4.708 kilowatt, and W2 is 11,913 watts or 11.913 kilowatts. Okay, so in this type of problem, it is a balanced load. We calculated the total true power, we calculated the resistance and reactance of load, star connected balanced load, and also we have calculated the reading of individual wattmeter. Okay, reading of individual wattmeter. Okay, is it clear? But thank you for today's session.